Marriage, it's a relationship wherein you actually, two different people come together, they start living together. And a lot of things that were previously small, small things unknown to each other start now coming into the focus. Let us get there. We'll eventually get there. What actually happens at the beginning of any relationship is quite simple. When a relationship begins, when there is some kind of rapport between two individuals. Are we together? The rapport could be physiological. Physiological rapport is all about the way of being physically. So the way of sitting maybe. It could be somebody is extremely happy standing like this. Another guy standing like this. They start to feel some commonality. There is some rapport that is built up. And from there a relationship sparks off. It could be something that the kind of language that is used. Something about the tone of voice that is used. It could be a situational rapport. So two people in the same situation also begin to start developing a rapport. But essentially all relationships start with a rapport. Well, you know, there's a very interesting twist on the definition of rapport. Somebody took rapport and made it into an acronym. So there's no original acronym for rapport. But this genius person made an acronym for rapport. This person said rapport actually means really all people prefer others like themselves. Others resembling themselves. So if you look at it, R-A-P-P-O-R-T. Right? But then if you really look at it, that's a fact. All people prefer others resembling themselves. That is how your rapport starts. Because somebody resembles you, or you think they resemble you, and that is how you build up rapport. Now, at the beginning of a relationship, there is a lot of rapport. At the beginning of a relationship, you do not have much information about the other individual. And as time goes on, you start finding out a lot of different things about that individual, which start breaking that rapport. As a relationship goes on, that rapport is broken. Due to different habits, due to different tastes, due to different upbringings, due to different cultures, it may be due to n number of reasons that the rapport starts breaking up. When we get into a relationship, please have a look at any relationship that you have developed so far. Every relationship started with rapport. And the relationships that you have continued with till now, on a good note, are the ones where you still have rapport. Tell me one relationship wherein the rapport was broken, the relationship is successfully maintained by you. Do you have any such relationship? Anyone? No?
All the marriages.
Okay. We'll not enter that territory. It's dangerous territory for now. So let's not enter there. But that is how a relationship progresses. Now, one vital thing that we forget as far as a relationship is concerned, that they are also influenced by a lot of different external forces. Things like your workplace pressures, your life demands, different life events. They're also influenced by your personality characteristics, the other person's characteristics, your family environments, your fatigue and stress levels across. So all these external factors are influencing you. They're also influencing the other person. And we fail to recognize that. And we assume that these things will continue to be the same for the both of us. And that's why the relationship should continue as it is. And unfortunately find that it doesn't work that way. So, what are really relationships all about? Please understand, relationships are not about love. Relationships are not about friendship. Relationships are not about profit. They are not about loss. They are about nothing of these. Relationships are always and always about relating with the other person. If you are able to relate to that person, that relationship will thrive. If you are unable to relate to that person, the relationship goes for a toss. A lot of us get into relationships with some kind of expectations from the other person. And when we find that those expectations are not being fulfilled, we start to think that the relationship is not worth it. I suggest think again. Is that really what a relationship is about? No, it is not. Every relationship is about relating to the other person, understanding things from their perspective. That is what a relationship is about. And this basic, if we can remember always, trust me, you'll find a lot of relationships start getting back on track. We tend to forget this particular basic and we keep up our expectations to a great degree. Reminds me of another story. Now this story, as stories go, so once upon a time, there was a beautiful garden. And in that beautiful garden was a strong and mighty oak. And the whole lawn was covered with a lot of green grass. And there came a storm. Have you heard this story before? Yes or no? No? I heard this story in my childhood. What do you think happened when the storm came? When the storm came, yes, you remember. Excellent. Correct. When the storm came in, the storm was a very furious storm. The oak was upright, strong. It refused to bend. It said, no, I will not bend. I am the mighty strong oak. And the storm fell the oak down. As far as the grass was concerned, nothing happened. The grass remained where it was. Because no matter what direction the storm blew in, the grass just bent that way. It went along with the storm. And the grass survived the storm. Unfortunately, in relationships, most of us, act like the strong, mighty oak and not like the grass. We think being the grass means compromising. Being the grass means giving up something. Being the grass means bowing down to someone. And that's why we prefer to be the strong, mighty oaks, splendid in our majesty. And while being the oak, what we slowly find is some kind of storm or the other comes in, creeps in, and we crash under the pressure. My dear friends, one of the most important facets of a successful relationship is the flexibility to flow along with the other person in that relationship. If you maintain that flexibility, you will find that the relationship continues as a strong and successful relationship. If not, remember the mighty oak and what happened to it. I also, while searching around, I found another story. I am in love with stories because these contain a lot of real life meanings hidden in a very nice way. So I found the story of the hare and the tortoise. This one I'm sure all of us must have read, right? At some point of time. So the story goes something like this. They decide to have a competition to find out who's the fastest runner, right? So then they go on, they start the race. The hare runs along. They decide to have a race. The hare runs along the route, runs along very fast. And it leaves the tortoise far behind. And then it thinks, uh-oh, let the poor guy plod along. Let me have some rest. So it stopped there, has some rest. The tortoise, however, the hare falls asleep. The tortoise, however, keeps plodding along. And as soon as the hare wakes up, it finds out the tortoise is already at the finish line. Finished. Isn't that the story that we have heard? Yes? Well, the story doesn't stop there. Then, you know, all these management gurus that come up with, you know, they come up with all kinds of new fundamentals in life, all fundas in life. But I loved this particular funda. So there was this one guru who came across with this funda and he says, the race did not stop there. The moral of this particular story was, slow and steady wins the race. This guru says that is old. In management, old stuff doesn't take around for long, does it? There's a new fundamental of operation. There's a new strategy. So this guy came up with a new version of the story. The story continues. So the hare was disappointed at losing the race and did some soul searching and then decided to do something different. Maybe the hare studied some NLP. So he found out that if it isn't working, do something different. So the hare decided to do something different and he decided in this race, no matter what happens, I will not stop till the race finishes. So he challenged the tortoise to another race. And the tortoise agreed because it had already won one race. So now, this time the hare went all the way right up to the finish line without stopping in between. And the hare won. The moral of the story? Relationship. One of the two people. Why does that?